God is opening your eyes to take it. Take your job you have been searching for. Take your business you have been searching for. Take what you have been kind for. You have been searching for it. God is honoring you. I'm not dying there. I'm not dying in poverty. I'm not dying in lack. I'm not dying in stress. I'm reaching my destiny. There's a place I'm seeing where God is taking me. Can I prophesy someone? You are going somewhere. Are you seeing a place where other people cannot see? It's where God is taking you.
Amen.
You can sit down. Thank you. God bless you. Pastors who are here can stand up. Can you stand up, pastors who are here? We want to welcome you. God bless you. Thank you. God bless you. Sit down. I mean, the way you are standing up, it's like you want to see who's standing first. It's like you are doubting to be a pastor. I'm also very worried. People of Charis, clap hands for yourself. Thank you. I wanted to tell you something that... God is good for you. And He wants to bless you today. Many of you don't believe you are defeated. And you are already defeated. There are things that has happened here. I had three groups. Those who were here from 2012, you saw it. The rebellion group. That's the affected group. And those that their minds are cleared. In other words, they don't know about anything. Because if you can read concerning
Joshua,
you find that Joshua never took what has happened. In the past. But Moses was so affected by the people of rebellion who ended up dying on the road, who could not inherit the Canaan. And the second group was those who were affected, also who say, let's choose a leader and turn back. But there was this new group that the Bible says they know nothing about Egypt, and they're the ones who entered Canaan. So these are the three groups I also experienced. And I found that if devil want to defeat a Christian, is when you are defeated and you rebel to, or you had an affected mind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read in the Bible, let's go there in Luke 1. Let's read from 26 to 31. Are you there?
Luke 1, 26 to 31.
Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee, named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, and the Lord is with thee. Can you see the verse there?
Amen.
But she was greatly troubled at the saying. She was greatly troubled at the saying, if you can read there, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this might be. You can see the problem here was the mind.
She
cast in a mind. And the angel said unto her, fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus.
Amen.
And you can read going down, he shall be great, he shall be called the Son of God, and whatever. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
You can read there, you can find something shocking when the angel appeared. Listen to this. Concerning what we have read, the problem was not the angel appearing. The problem was the words that were given to Mary. When she heard that, the Bible says she cast in her mind. In other words, she was questioning, because your mind is there to check the words if they suit you or not. Your mind is there to take the word or to reject the word. So now, when she was still thinking, she checked what kind of words have been given. I don't understand. I can see this person is the angel, but the words brought fear. Those words didn't bring faith, they brought fear. That's why the angel says, fear not, because there is something big that you need to believe is coming. Listen to this. If you can read there, you will realize that this mind of Mary, already because of the background and the family situation, was also putting her in danger of not accepting what God wanted to do on that time. Because if now she has been greeted like a king, hail, and she knows that even she's not even married,
the man
she's having, they just betrothed to each other. But the Bible says she believed the promise and she possessed the reasons. She was told that she does not need to fear, because she was casting in her mind why she can be greeted that way. In other words, there were some ways that when she thinks we're not fit for a position, there are some promises that when she looks at herself, she finds that she doesn't deserve such kind of promises. Listen to this. It says, goodness, I come to you and say, you are going to be a millionaire. Automatically, when you cast in your mind, when you check in your mind, already because your mind is defeated, you won't accept that. This is what Mary did. She thought about it. She questioned the greetings. And she said, I'm a very small person. How can I be greeted that way? Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what I say, my friend. Your mind is affecting your destiny, either negatively or positively. Because you can be here in the church and you pray too much, but when the promises come, you find that you feel they don't deserve you. Sometimes you look at yourself because of the background of the family and you ask yourself, no, I can't drive this car. Oh, I can't have this house. Oh, I can't marry this person. Why? Because of the experiences of the past. But I'm here to speak like this angel, that whatever that God is going to promise you today, it shall come to pass in your life. I have read in Colossians 2,
verse 11,
and I found that our minds, they can be our enemies. Our minds can be our enemies. Because look here, you look at yourself, you figure out the destiny. But because how you were tailor-made, the experiences of the past or of now, you find that when you judge yourself by your mind, you feel you're not suitable to the blessing. I don't know if you're hearing me. Many of you here, maybe you're supposed to be a president, but when you think in your mind, nobody in your mind, in your mind, in your family, has ever been a president. So you question yourself when your mind is trying to assess the words you are being told. You look at yourself and you write yourself off. Today, we need to deal with our minds and we try to face reality. Reality of the word. When the Bible says you are the head, you are not the tail. You take it as it is. Not looking at your situation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My friend, don't be afraid of your mind. Is there for the positive things. Because I found that there are different kinds of minds when I'm reading the Bible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pastor say, my friend, what kind of mind are you having? There's in 2 Corinthians 8:12, if we can write it down.
8:12.
We found a willing mind. If you want God to use you, you must have a willing mind. Willing
mind.
If you are willing and obey, you will eat the good of the land. A willing mind. Listen to this. Jesus gave a parable.
And
he said there were two sons. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
And the father came and said, I'm saving you. And the first one. And the first one said, I'm going. But there was no willingness. It was just like a word just to come to bring an information to the father. Whereas somebody won't do it. But the second one said, I can't go. Later this person repented. Because willingness comes from repentance. You cannot just rush to have willingness before you repent. The moment you repent, you receive strength to achieve what God wants to achieve. To act the way God wants to act. Many of us, we want to have a willing heart. But because we are just agreeing. Whereas repentance is not there. Because repentance shows us the way. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's what my friend. Repentance makes you to see reality the way it is. So if you have got a willing heart, you will follow the way God wants you to follow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read Ruth 1,
verse 18,
you find a steadfast mind. Ruth was having a steadfast mind. A steadfast mind is a mind of a Christian. Because Ruth says, I'm not seeing hopes from this mama, but I have seen God in her life. So what I can do is to follow her, though I can't see with my naked eyes. In other words, Ruth was saying, I have got faith that God can still do it, though there is nothing. Because steadfast mind establishes your strength. Tell a neighbor, steadfast mind establishes your strength. We need Christians who can stand and say, I'm seeing what I'm seeing, but I'm not shaken. Because though there's no sign of a miracle of where I'm going, But I'm holding until to the end. If we can have such Christians, such Christians will be victorious Christians. That's what I say, my friend. Are you having a steadfast mind? A steadfast mind cannot be shaken, cannot be taken anywhere. When you read the book of Psalms 1, it says the wicked are like chaffs. They can be carried by wind. So any wind that can come, it will never blow you anywhere. We need Christians who are saying what God has promised, I will hold until I see what He has promised. And I believe what He has promised will come to pass. If we can have that mind, you will hold the word until you have the results of that word. If you have that mind, you can stay in the word like what Joshua was told. It was not easy. When God said, Joshua, meditate the word of God day and night. In other words, have a steadfast mind. Hold the scriptures until you prosper, and the scriptures will make you to prosper. That's what I say, my friend. What is it that is affecting your mind? There are some Christians who are here that devil is shaking your understanding. He's dealing with your stand. Today, you can take him away from you and establish your stand and tell yourself, I'm not leaving God until He blesses me. Ruth says, I can't leave you. Wherever you go, I go. Where you lie, I lie. Where you die, I will die. Look what happened to Ruth. We are still talking about her. You can write your history by not shaking when you see the situations, but by holding one way. Listen to prophesy. Where you are looking, God is taking you there. If it is your destiny, it will happen very fast. I said there's no delay in your destiny. Carry on looking until you reach there. Carry on looking until you reach there. Somebody is here today. God is taking you there. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Any delay in your life is there to affect your mind. Trouble you're facing your mind. Many of you can't talk about yourself because already you are defeated. You talk about other people. He who's been defeated, he tried to underrate others so that he used them as steps to go forth. But he who knows where he's going, he doesn't mind about what is happening around. He hold the word and it becomes a step for him to his destiny. If you believe, say amen. Ask your neighbor, say, my friend, what is it that is disturbing your mind? Serve God when it's tough. Serve God when you are poor. Serve God when it's difficult. Serve God when they are rejecting you. Serve God. Can you serve God when you are facing what you are facing? The same God will bless you in front of your enemies. If you believe, shout hallelujah. In 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, it talks about the sound mind. The mind, the sound mind. A mind that, you know, always when you speak the word, it is seasoned with salt. You know, the sound mind is a mind that does not have fear. It's a mind that believes in the promises of God. The sound mind is there for Christians. It has got a rhythm. When you are listening to the rhythm, you can know where the person is going. If you are listening to the sound, you can detect what is the meaning of that sound. Whether the sound is bringing a music.
What kind of music,
whether you like it or not. Allow your mind to bring out a sound that God will be pleased with. When God is looking at your thoughts, he began to say, I've got someone like Job. Job never loses mind when he's facing problems. I don't know if you're hearing that. When the wife was affected, he was never affected. Listen, your destiny is determined by how you react out of your mind. Tell your neighbor, your destiny is determined by how you react out of your mind. You can be a failure because your mind has been affected. Job says, I cannot be stupid and curse God because of my situation around me. Listen to this. Christians that will prosper and become the best are those that their minds, when God look at it, he can hear the rhythm. Like what happened when Paul and Silas was in prison, and when they are thinking about the stripes, and they began to say, it's better we worship our God than to look at the pain we are facing. And when God was looking at their mind, when they are singing, God began to shake his leg, and the leg caused an earthquake on prison. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pastor said, my friend, there is something that I'm hearing in my mind. There is something I'm removing. No, many people who have got problem of the mind is because of the things of the past. Are you hearing that? It's because of the things of the past. Others can't move forward because they've been affected there. Not long I found some people, and then I found that because you grew up when your parents didn't have money, your mind has been affected. You can't buy yourself food. Even yourself, you become selfish to yourself. But money is there. You find that, you know, you buy a loaf that will finish the whole week. And when on Friday, that loaf is having some green things. Because when your mind is affected, even your stomach is affected. Can you tell your neighbor? When your mind is affected, even your stomach is
affected.
That is why when you go home, when you find that the refrigerator is off, you'll be questioning God, why you didn't make this electricity to be on forever?
Why?
Well, you know what you put there. You don't want to go and buy again. And what you put there is for the whole month. And your stomach is affected. Sometimes when you've got runny stomach, you say it's God. That is your mind. Many people who are very sick, I mean mentally, you know, it's not those who are crazy. Are Christians who can reason the word. I mean, a Christian who doesn't reason the word, he is even worse than a crazy person. Because he doesn't live his life. Are you hearing that?
Amen.
Can you ask your neighbor, say, my friend, how is your mind affecting you? Are you defeated? Uring. Can you look at the person? Uring.
What is she or he saying?
Some of you, because you face rejection in the past, you forget about lipstick now. You can't deal with yourself because already you are defeated. I mean, you just buy a big Vaseline and you are losing complexion.
complexion
because your appearance also it goes by how far your mind has been trained. Tell somebody, say package yourself. Say package yourself. Don't leave yourself. Package yourself. Somebody just find that you don't even deal with yourself. You have got a light complexion better than me, but you are like me now. Why? Because already you find that you are not packaging yourself. Can I prophesy someone? There is someone today. You are receiving favor. As you are dealing with yourself, dealing with your mind, you are receiving favor. There are things that you are removing. There are things that you are removing. You don't need them. There are things that you don't want. As you are thinking, bring some things that will help you. I prophesy favor upon your life. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Let me take you to another scripture. Maybe you will understand. If you read James
1,
from 6 to 8, it says, 6 to 8, double-minded man cannot receive anything. In other words, God is not happy about people who think double. You think yes, tomorrow is no. And the Bible says that man must never think. By the mind which is double, even when you think, God won't approve it. That man must never think that he will receive anything from God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I believe if you think another mind, automatically you have got a carnal mind. Because there are two kinds of mind. Spiritual mind and a carnal mind. So if you can have two at the same time, you can't please God. I don't know if you're hearing that. If you read Romans 6:8, verse 6. The Bible says, to be carnally minded is death, and to be spiritual minded is life and peace. Are you there? If you go to Ephesians 3:20, God is able to do above what you think. You must think so that God will do above. Don't just relax. When somebody asks you and say, what kind of job you want? You say, any job. If you are lazy to think, you will take anything. I don't know if you're hearing me. To be carnal minded is death. It means if you've got a mind which does not correspond with the word of God, you won't think things that will happen. We need Christians that will think and God does above. You are thinking Mercedes-Benz C200 and God gives you ML. We need to have that kind of it's not wrong to think something. It is not prosperity gospel. God wants to think right. Remember the Bible says your life is hidden above. So think above. Think about your God. Where God is. What God can do. Don't look at your ability. Don't look at your mistakes of the past. Don't look at your failure. I prophesy someone that whatever you are thinking, God will do the double. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Ask your neighbor, what are you thinking? Stop thinking about, hey, I can't get money to pay electricity. It's like we are eating too much. The food is being finished so quick. You are inviting Satan. Even when you want to pray and think, God won't do it. We need Christians who are saying we are not failures. I'm thinking the best. Think the best. Your God is big. You can't serve big God and remain small. small. Can I prophesy you? Today, God will give you ideas, plans that will materialize in your life. In the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I need you to remove failure. Mistakes. Don't dwell in your mistakes. Don't dwell in your failures. God wants to take you forward. Forward you go. Forward you go. Backward never. Stagnation must die. Think. God will do the rest. I don't know if you're hearing me. Ask somebody close to you and say, what are you thinking about? Uring.
A ring.
What are you thinking about? You know, you hear somebody say, I don't know.
I can say.
The person starts by, I don't know. Is that I have children with this person? I was supposed to be divorcing. If I don't have children, are you blaming these children? You don't know what to do.
I would say,
where do you blame the children? Where is your
daughter?
Because some people, when they can't think, they can attack everybody on their mistakes. Sometimes when you can't think, you point people.
Say,
this one is the cause of my failure. You look at your parents, you curse them. If they send me to school, I could not face this. But if you think you will know that they didn't send you to school to prove that God can still raise you when you didn't go to school, I want the rejected person to think you're a celebrity. I want the poor person to think about riches. I want the one who's sick to see yourself as healed. Can you just think and think and believe that God, as he has loved you, is going to make it possible for you to receive above what you are thinking? Can you stand? Can you stand? Can we crush every evil thoughts that is really affecting our destiny? Because devil says you're a failure, you're a loser, look where you are. I mean, you can't go anywhere. I want you to lift your hands and begin to remove all things that devil put in your life. The mistakes that you have committed, forgive yourself. You are not a failure. Think right. Plan right. Pray. What are you thinking? Prayer. What are you thinking, Baba? I remove doubt. I remove failure. I remove. I'm thinking right.
Kenana chatuko. Thank you, Jesus.
Think.
Nah,
and pray.
Rappel.
Think. in Jesus.
Keep watching, Charis.